Hello guys, Cyber Dragon here, and welcome to What Up Deku with Bradley, part 8? Yeah, 8. So, this is not going to be a very long part, this will mostly be about the USJ, but yeah. So, there's really no point in what we need to do at the moment, so let's begin. So, we begin with Deku on the bus ride to the USJ. And his internal thoughts, today will be the day. But I don't see All Might on the bus. Let's hope the plan still goes well. As they are reaching there, Sue looks at Midoriya and asks, "Hey Bradley, why do you have the eye patch on, Ribbit?" "Yeah, that's been killing me for a while. So, I even tried to ask you the first day, but Jiro jabbed me with her earphones." "That's because it was rude to ask at that time. What makes a difference now? We're finally sick and tired of being patient and wanting to not know now." That sounds hypocritical. "Well, screw you." "It's quite alright. It's actually to block off part of my quirk." "What is your quirk?" "It is just called the All-Seeing Eye. This quirk allows me to see any flaws, weaknesses, or invisibility there is. I can do a lot with this quirk, and, well, it gives me pinpoint accuracy." "So that's how you were able to see me?" "Yes. But I do try to look away from you specifically, because, you know." Right. So wait, you can see him naked right now? "Yes, and if you dare try to make me look at her, Mineta, I'll chop that thing off between your legs."
"Understand, sir."
"Good.
He's so kind."
Hakakure is still forming that little crush on Deku, but this will be the day that they will know anything. "Ew, pinpoint accuracy, huh? That means he knows where to hit the right spot." God, I hate how we made Umuraka like a whore in this. But after they got to the USJ, 13 greeted them. While in Deku's head, "Damn. I have no way of contacting the League and let them know that All Might isn't here. This could be bad. I'm gonna have to hope the plan can still go well." So 13 does her whole spiel about how quirks are dangerous and whatnot. Till the light starts to flicker. Showtime. As Deku acts surprised along with everyone else, asking, "What's going on? Hey, you guys even got fake villains. What?" As Aizawa looks down to see the villains. Koryu warping them all. Shit. So, everyone get back. They're real villains.
Oh my god, what?
Calm down, everyone. We must be calm in this situation. He's right. 13, Bradley. Get the students out of here. I'll take care of them. Understood. Damn, I need Kurogiri to get up here fast. As Aizawa goes down to fight, Kurogiri shows up in the nick of time. "Where do you think you're going? You will not be So isn't this a fitting place to see the symbol of peace, All Might, to die? I thought he was supposed to be here today." As 13 is back preparing quick, and Deku thinking, should I slash her? Bakugo and K Kirishima interrupts the attack of 13 and attacks Kurigiri. As he puts his blade back, some people didn't notice, but thinking because Kirishima and Bakugo got in the way that they can't, you know, he can't attack properly. Highly untrue, but still. The attack doesn't go through, and well, Kurigiri does start to warp them all away. As Deku doesn't go to the water zone this time, no, he goes to a very far off zone. So, to making sure Hakakure and Todoroki doesn't go to the same zone as Deku this time, he goes to the zone that, you know, that those two were at. Oh, that was a bit of... so unpleasant. My job here is now just to observe. See if the fight happens as it should. Hey, we found a kid! Seems like they didn't want me to be unscathed, just in case. Very well. Do you all know who I am? No, and why should that matter? Good. So they haven't told anybody at here who I truly am. But, just to be sure, I will have to deal with all of you. As he draws out his blades. Huh, what are you gonna do? Kill us? Precisely. Yeah, right, you're trying to be a hero. There's no way that, as Deku bolts over to that villain who said that, stabbing him in the throat. As the villain looks surprised and coughs up blood violently. Will you shut up? As he retrieves his blade, cutting his head clean off. Jesus, you just killed him! Yes, and that will be the fate of all of you. Now, come. Accept your fate with dignity. As some villains rushes towards Deku, Deku blitz past all of them who were charging towards him, and at a brief moment it looks like nothing happened, but when Deku stands up properly, all of those villains drops dead, blood squirting from them. The villains who still has an attack, the far range one starts to fire, as the other ones who has close range attacks starts to run away. Sorry, but I can't let you all do that. As Deku starts to kill them off one by one. Eventually, he does get done with his zone. As All Might appears. Finally. Now, let's see the show. So, the fight can go the same as in canon, just someone else jumping in to save All Might. As the heroes got there, and Nomu was defeated. Damn. Well, I better get down there. As all the heroes are arresting the villains, all the students are being gathered up as Vlad King. Is everyone here? Wait, where's Bradley? Izuku? Big Dick Bradley? That was Umaraka and Midnight's Mine. Everyone starts to look. No need to threat, I'm here. As he starts to walk towards them. All three of those girls in their minds, thank God, as he has blood dripping from his blades. Well, it was a very eventful evening. But let's go as the Nomu re-crash in through the USJ. Huh? This could be a problem. As the Nomu shrieks out to everyone, he looks for someone to attack. Spots Midnight. As in All Might's mind, I can't move or fight him. So someone else had to. As the Nomu lunges at Midnight and throws a punch. Midnight braces for impact until Deku cuts off the arm of the Nomu. It falls to the ground and the Nomu screams, "Don't you even dare!" As Deku rushes at the Nomu, the eye patch does fly off, and he moves faster than most people can see. Deku starts to slash and cut at the Nomu, and went for his stab, but the Nomu restrains his hand and the sword as he stabs into the Nomu's hand. And it broke the blade. But the blade is still in the Nomu's hand, as Deku pulls out another blade and slits under the Nomu's leg and stabbing its knee. The Nomu keeps on punching, but Deku keeps on dodging, avoiding, and attacking. Umaraga wants to help Deku to show that she is, you know, to make her seem great. She runs to Sato. Sato, yeah? Break up some rocks and Zero, tape them and throw them at the thing. I'll use my zero gravity to make it easier. Are you sure? Because Bradley is there as well. Yes, he will be fine, I'm sure. So they do as they say, and they start to throw rocks at the Nomu. While everyone is shocked and wondering what are they doing, Deku sees the rocks incoming. What the fuck are those idiots doing? As Deku is now dodging the rocks, then the Nomu uses the hand with the blade in it, stuck it into Deku's chest. As Deku looks surprised, and everyone was shocked, and Midnight's eyes widen in tears, and as she's covering her mouth, Hizuku, as the Nomu lifts up Deku, using the other hand to grab his head. But Deku uses the other sword he still has in his hand, stabbing the Nomu in the brain. The Nomu lets go, and Deku stabs it repeatedly until it dies. As Deku now tries to stand up, as he vomits out blood and pulling out the broken blade that's in his chest, as Midnight runs up to him and hugs him. No, Mary? As Midnight kisses him passionately, as Deku kisses back, everyone except the teachers were shocked at the fact that they are kissing. They break the kiss, and Deku coughs up some more blood. Izuku, are you okay? As Midnight eyes are tearing up. I think so. As Midnight looks at the wound. It's a clean stab, but you're losing some blood as she is putting pressure on his wound. Deku places his hand on top of hers. Well, sorry to worry you a lot. I know, but can we get a medic? Some medics come by and get Deku, fixing and up the stab wound and stopping the bleeding, etc.
So much for our plans tonight.
I know. As Midnight hugs him, I'm just glad you're okay.
How am I so lucky to have you?
I know you are, but and I'm lucky to have you. And 1A approaches Deku to make sure he's okay. Except for the three who threw the rocks. They are getting scolded by Nezu. Bradley, are you okay? As all of 1A's behind Momo.
I'm fine. I got stabbed, but I'm fine.
Yeah. So, are you and Midnight, like, a thing? Like a teacher-student relationship?
Not at first.
We met 2 years ago.
Oh, okay.
And, well, just look. As everyone's eyes widen at seeing a ring on both Deku and Nomuri's hands.
You guys are married?
Oh shit, you're married. As Dinky and Mineta are thinking all the things that they said, not on just on the bus ride that Deku, as I didn't mention, but every other time they mention how hot Midnight was.
Yes.
We're so fucked. You know, it makes a lot of sense now. Yeah, and how would Midnight would look at you?
Yeah.
I'm crushing on a man, on a married man.
Oh my god.
Okay, calm down. You didn't confess. Oh, this bitch. We'll see who will get him. As, after a while, Deku had to be taken to Recovery Girl. Even despite him saying he's fine, Midnight insisted on it, and he just sighed in agreement. After a while, Recovery Girl checked his wounds. It will take some time to heal, but you should be good to go home at least. Come by every now and again, so I can heal your wound, so the recovery process is faster. Thank you. As all of 1A is still waiting inside to see Deku in the bed.
So, are you gonna be okay?
Yes. Recovery Girl said we'll be fine. Ah, that's good. Then, out of nowhere,
Mama! Papa!
As everyone looks at Eri, both Midnight and Deku.
Eri?
As Eri runs up to Deku.
Are you okay?
As she is tearing up. And Deku picks up Eri.
I'm fine, Eri.
Sir.
Good.
As Eri hugs him, and Deku hugs him back.
You have a kid?
Well, adopted, but still, yes.
She's so cute!
She's mine. So, as that was the rest of 1A who didn't know. So, back off, Mina. She's mine. You know that. As Midnight hugs Eri. Eri hugs her back, and everyone just kind of looks at the happy family. Hugger Curry's mine. I had a crush on a married man who also had a kid.
It would have been real awkward if you confessed.
But Eri, who brought you here to the Recovery Girl's office?
Eri, don't run!
Of course.
Sorry, but I just wanted to make sure my papa was okay.
Who are you exactly? Oh, she's one of my students who was supposed to be babysitting her.
I'm sorry, but she just was crying and wanted to see her dad, and I didn't want to say no.
It's fine, as Deku's patting Eri's head. But don't you have class? But your class last time, who watched her let her into events of UA? Yeah, sorry. Well, thank you for looking after her at least. As he was about to hand $300 to Nijire.
Oh, there's no need. Babysitting her is all my payment I need.
Very well then. as Deku gives the money to Midnight. But, thank you all for coming to see me, and I'm fine. I would like to spend some time with my family.
Oh, okay, bye, Aerie. Bye, big sis.
Oh my god, I'm a big sister now!
Yes, but we aren't adopting you.
Aww. Yeah, no, we're not adopting you. As everyone just laughs. But that will more or less be the end of this part. I'm sorry this isn't very long. But honestly, we didn't have much planned for it. I think this was about... I want to say... Yeah, 20 minutes, which... Yeah,
I think it's a good amount of time,
more or less. I hope you all enjoyed this part, however. There will be some filler stuff, however, in the next few parts as well. Like a get well party for Deku after all that and whatnot. And yeah, I hope you all enjoy. Cyber Dragon out. Peace.